I think the people who would be watching whether this lead test rod works is anyone who owns a reactor, anyone who sells fuel for a reactor, anyone who operates reactors, anyone who's thinking about building a reactor inside and outside the US. Because this is one of those problems that it happens everywhere, right? Happens in Korea, happens in Japan, happens especially in the US. It's particularly bad here because we're a market-based economy. So we have to drive our plants harder than most state-owned countries do to get more power out of them. And driving them harder produces more crud. So if anyone's looking, it's the US nuclear industry in its entirety. Because we can remove not only hundreds of millions of dollars of lost revenue, but the uncertainty on that, making nuclear a less risky prospect. And then it might compete with natural gas, and we can stop shutting down plants because they're temporarily more expensive. So let's say this idea works, and then let's say, how would it work? Well, we're going to put some, we've got these long nuclear fuel rods, and we're going to put a little patch of material on different places on these rods. If those patches stay shiny and the other stuff is covered in crud, it worked. The next step is an LTA, a lead test assembly, which means you take a bundle of about 17 by 17 fuel rods and you make a whole assembly out of it. If we can do that, then we'll have effectively commercialized the process anyway, because to coat a few hundred odd fuel rods takes a lot of effort. Step after that is it's a product. Someone's going to go sell it. So you might think, can we coat the current rods in this new stuff, or do we have to coat new rods? You got to coat new rods. Fortunately, you cycle rods out of a reactor about every 4.5 years, and you refuel about a third of the reactor at a time. So every year and a half, you could substitute in about a third of the reactor, and in 4.5 years, it's all the new stuff. So it wouldn't take long for this process to be fully realized in industry, and that's what I'm going after. So to get to where we are now, it's taken about $5.5 million of R&D investment over a period of 7 years. And it might cost a few hundred thousand to $1 million to coat a reactor's worth of fuel rods. But right there, you've already made your money back by a factor of 2. Because you don't have to ultrasonically clean the fuel, and you don't have to buy extra fresh fuel assemblies to deal with crud. That's how they deal with it right now. In addition, all of the unknowns, the 10K per percent power per day, the 1 million to 2 million a day from unplanned outages, the extra radiation dose you're getting to workers, which I'm sure somebody could quantify, if those disappear, that's a return on investment in the factors of 100. And this problem here summarizes how I run my research group. When I was getting hired at MIT, I was asked a lot of questions, and some of them were easy, some of them were hard, but one of them was deep. The deep one was asked by Neil Todrius. He said, "So what are you not going to study? And why?" And there's easy answers to this question that are incorrect, like, I'm not going to study biology, right? Nobody cares. I thought for a little while, and I said, I'm not going to study anything that doesn't have industry connections in 5 years. There's a lot of people here at MIT who are studying basic science that might take 20 or 50 years to market, might never get to market, might go all about understanding how the universe works, and that's okay. We need those sorts of people. But it's not what makes me tick. It's not what keeps me up at night in a good way. So everything I do, I want to see it get out of my lab and into a product or a service or something that people can use in 5 years. Now, this is particularly important for the nuclear power industry because it's not in good shape right now. Natural gas is so cheap in the US that people are shutting down plants not because they're not safe, not because they don't work, but because they're more expensive than natural gas. And this, in the long run, is going to be a catastrophe for the energy mix in the US. Having a huge source of carbon-free baseload power, to me, it's all about domestic energy security. And if we're ditching our nuclear plants because they're temporarily more expensive, despite being numerically the safest power source on Earth, we're making a gigantic mistake for short-term profits.